Today, I'm going to show you why I'm switching from MyPy to TUI for all of my Python projects. If you're using type hints in Python, you've most likely felt the pain of MyPy's slow performance, confusing error messages, and terrible third-party support. Well, that's all about to change with this new Rust-based type checker from Astral, which promises to fix all of those issues and much more. And if you've never heard of Astral before, well, they're the team behind some really cool Python tooling like Ruff and UV. We've actually spoken about UV in this channel before. Check out the link in the description to see that video. But in this video, we're going to talk about some of TUI's features like module discovery, type suppression, and we'll check out its VS Code plugin. But before we do any of that, let's actually see exactly how much faster TUI is than MyPy. And trust me, you don't want to miss this. So this is the repo for Home Assistant, an open source home automation platform that has over 200,000 lines of Python code, and it's also full of type hints. If we run MyPy on the whole project, we can see it takes over 113 seconds. But if we run TY on the same project, we can see it takes just under 7 seconds. That's almost 20 times faster than MyPy, but for small projects, the difference is tiny. TY automatically searches for first-party modules in the source directory, but you could also update the pyproject.toml file if you have a different structure. It also automatically searches for a VM file if you're not in a virtual directory, which helps prevent these missing stub errors that you'd otherwise get from MyPy if you're not in a virtual environment. Speaking of MyPy, just like MyPy's overrides, TY has rules that can be configured in the pyproject.toml file, a ty.toml file, or just in the CLI. Let's say I wanted to ignore this invalid typeform error. I could just add this rule with a value of ignore, warn, or error, which would suppress that specific type error. But what if I just wanted to apply this rule to a single line of code and not the whole project? Then I could use a suppression comment with ty ignore and the name of the rule, but I could also use the standard type ignore. On a separate note, check out the error message for this error from MyPy, which is a bit cryptic compared to the same error from TY, which shows you the exact line the type error is happening on, as well as the line number and the rule to disable this type of error, which is more than what you'd get from MyPy Pretty. But as much as I like looking at type errors in the terminal, it's much easier to do it in my editor. And this is where the VS Code plugin comes in handy, which shows the type error in line and gives you the rule to disable the type in the pop-up window. Even though TY is in preview and not yet ready for production, it already has more than 7K stars on GitHub, which shows that people really want this. And it also gives me hope that maybe just one day, the tooling for Python will be as good as the tooling for JavaScript.